Click. Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of Muscletonebullys. So today is an interesting episode. I haven't done this before, but since we've been really excited about the King Kong and Matilda breeding, it's our first micro breeding that we're doing, that we are more than positive we're going to get nothing but micros, only because I know King Kong's throwing a lot of micros, a lot of 12 and 11 and 10 inch dogs, even 9 inch dogs, when he's bred to smaller bitches. Knowing Matilda comes from a line of nothing but 12-inch and below dogs for 3 to 4 generations, I'm expecting at least 90% of the litter to be micros, if not the entire litter. Based on my calculations, we'll see if I'm right or wrong. So we are on our way now to do the C-section for Matilda. She's big as a house. I'm expecting at least, 7 to 8 puppies. Let's see if I'm right. I'm going to take you on this journey with us. So we're on our way to the vet now. So I live in Naples and my vet is in Miami. So it's an hour and a half, hour and 40 minute drive. I can't go too quick, too fast in this particular vehicle with the dogs in the back and a pregnant female. So it's going to take about that long. So once we arrive, we're going to film and take you through the journey with us. So follow us. Just arrived, and we also have Porscha here today. Who's being bred to King Kong, so we brought Kong with us as well. So we got Matilda for the C-section. We got Kong for an AI. This is how our days go. We got breeding, C-sections. We got all kinds of stuff going on every day.
So surgical with Porscha first. Now let's check out the semen. See how the semen's looking. How's the semen, Caesar? Amazing.
You want me to send you the video?
Yeah, send it to me. Oh yeah, look at that. Great. So King Kong semen is pretty impressive considering we ate him Friday? So we ate at him on Friday and on Saturday. We gave him Sunday off and we collected him today. And he's been AI'd almost every day this week and last week and the week before. Yeah. Between freezing and breeding our dogs and other clients' dogs, it's like the dog has not stopped. I can't believe that his count's still this high. But I think it has a lot to do with nutrition and a lot to do with genetics as well. So, his dad was that way and his grandfather was that way. So, and the list goes on. So, Porsche's done, as you guys can see. She's ready for a C-section. She's about to go in. Come on, girl. Table, so she's about to have her babies. So we're gonna film it. But these are pretty big puppies, so we're gonna go. I mean, obviously, it varies per pup. But for me, it seems to be 6 is the number. Sometimes 7 or 8, depending how big these puppies are. That's the first feeding before I hit the road, because I got a 2-hour drive, so I want to make sure that, you know, they have some food in them in case something happens in the remote.
Okay.
I always listen to make sure there's nothing in there that hasn't been sucked out. And everything's good. Not aspirating or anything. If they are, we use a sucky with a little pump to pump it out. So we measure from the back of the ribs to the mouth. I hold it. Now, we usually mark it, but in my case, I know how to do it, so I'm just gonna do it with one hand. Feed it to them. Just like that. You can see. You want to hear the screaming, and the screaming is very important. Now mark it if you haven't done this before, but I don't because I have experience and I know how far to get it, and I measure with my fingers. I hold on to it with my fingers. You hold it there, steady pace. You want to hold the head up. You try to keep their feet off the ground so they don't move around too much. The screaming is very important. If they're screaming, you're doing a good job. Eventually, they calm down because their belly is getting full. I stop before there's any air in there. Pinch. Pull out. Pinching is the most important.
Morning.
And that one is done.
One of the yes.
The breeding with King Kong and Porscha is completed. If you have any questions about that, reach out to Cruel Bulls on Instagram. So that's at KRUELBULLS. Again, at KRUELBULLS. That's on Instagram. Jordan's the owner of Porscha, and he'll be having that litter with King Kong. And I'm telling you guys, this is a litter you don't want to miss out at. Contact him for pricing. I'm not too sure what the pricing is going to be, but contact him to reserve one. They're going to go quick. This is a very, very, very serious breeding, guys. I mean, like, it's probably, this is breeding that I was going to do myself, but I gave the opportunity to someone else because I have too much of that blood in my yard already. This is the future right there. That kind of combination is going to build you foundation, show quality dogs, and everything that you can think of in one. You're looking for a foundation dog to build your program around. This is definitely one of them. So, for that being complete, now as for Matilda, we were hoping for some boys, but we didn't get any boys. We got 5 beautiful females. They all look like Matilda. As of now, obviously, they're newborns. All newborns look the same, but they look pretty promising. They're all healthy, strong lungs. They all look great. They had their first feeding, and now we're on our way home for their, 2-hour drive before they get their next one. We'll be updating you guys as the time goes by. I don't take many pictures of my puppies because, one, I don't have them on hand to get to go to the whelper, and I don't see them until they're like 6, 7, 8 weeks sometimes. So when she updates me, I post up and I update, or when clients ask me, I'll get updates for them, privately. But usually don't take pictures of newborns. It's just, they're newborns. Really not much to look at until they're a couple months old. So that concludes our episode for today. Any questions? You guys know how to reach out to us. See you next episode.